Rafa, pleasure to see you. Thank you very much for coming in here at Absolute. Got to ask you firstly, this coaching app, right now, I'm doing some coaching now. I'm starting to do some.
That's good.
Finally, because I'm doing a lot of talking and people say, why don't you get out there and do it yourself? So I'm going to do it myself. What can I get from this coaching app?
To be fair, we were preparing something for us, no, for my staff, trying to show the players how to do patterns of play, for example, exercises, training sessions you can put together. And you can analyze games. You can watch a game. You can put the shape of both teams, send by email. That's it. You can send your exercises. So thinking about young coaches, thinking about academies, you can share your exercises. You can share your training sessions. You can send by email. And everybody can use the same. For somebody, you say, okay, we want to play as Barcelona.
Yes.
Okay. So everybody will say, oh, we have to create a style from the academy. All the coaches, they will have the same exercises or the same training sessions, control it for a technical director or the manager, and then you can follow the same routes, everyone. So I think you will see that this, and also it's very interactive, very easy to manage. If you don't know about computers, like a lot of people,
like
it's just to move players.
Like me, I'm not good.
But it's very simple. You will see that it's just to move players with your finger.
And what about for somebody who, like when I watch a game, Rafa, I tend to watch the ball and stuff and just watch the forwards. That's just what I normally do. And maybe the midfield player who's going to maybe feed me the ball. How would you watch it as a coach? I'm asking you for your insight now. How should I watch the game now as a coach who wants to be a coach? Do I have to watch what the right back's doing, what the left back's? How do you watch that game without watching the ball? Can this app teach you this?
No, the app is can explain to you, can show you how to do some patterns that you have been training. So it's not a miracle. It's okay, keep the app and we will win every game. No chance. I was watching Bayern the other day, Bayern Munich training, and they have a Japanese player, and he couldn't understand any word. So he has a translator on the pitch during the training session.
Running with him?
Yeah, with him. So then I said, if you have the app, you can explain the exercises, and then he will see the exercises. So it's very easy, because you watch everything, and you don't need the explanation. No?
And so this is the natural way forward now. Would you say this is the natural way forward for coaches? This is going to be something that's going to be happening?
Yeah, I have been working with programs with computers for years, no? And then however you have your laptop or your PC at home, you go, you put your exercises, you have a database. We have a program that we have database of players, training sessions and games. But you have to go at home or you have to use your laptop with the iPad. You go on the pitch and you can show the patterns and you can show the exercises, so they will understand very, very easy.
And what's it called? I talked about some of the European games the other day, great European night the other day in the Champions League, Chelsea coming back against Napoli. I couldn't see it personally that it was going to happen because Napoli's such a counter-attacking side, and Chelsea with their kind of, I don't know, they're not playing so great, the manager's gone and everything. Is that kind of game make you feel like I want to be back in there again?
Yeah, for sure. Did you always, when you are watching these games, you know the players, you know the style, and then you have your game plan in your head, so I will do this, I will do that. That is another experience. When you play a different level, you play even the Premier League, it's fine, so it's a great atmosphere. But when you go to Europe, and especially at this stage of the competition, it's massive.
Yeah, but how can you look at Napoli, and they play so well at home, really good. Obviously, the crowd helps. And then they come to Chelsea needing to score something like 4 goals. Italy, renowned for defending. What happened there, Rafa? What was it?
Well, if you remember the game, the first 50 minutes, Napoli had 2 or 3 chances.
Yeah.
So they could change the game, and after they were quite comfortable in possession, so they were playing the ball on the pitch, they were passing the ball, they were going forward, and at the end when they needed to score another goal, even Lavezzi was going to receive between the lines, turning and then looking for the striker. So I think that Napoli was doing his game. Maggio, that is a right winger or wing back, he had an injury, so they have to change Zuniga to the right and then Dossena on the left, and change a little bit because Mayo physically is strong and he's good in the air. He can get into the box, but he can defend. So all these things together at the end were against Napoli, but I think that they do a good game.
I was very surprised that they weren't more defensive-minded, especially once Chelsea got a couple of goals. But you have to say, with the attitude of the Chelsea players, I think that's something that you can't really coach too much, that English tempo. They kept going. Is that something that you would try to mix with the intricate play as well? You need this attitude. Yeah,
you will know this player, Luis García.
Yes.
I told Luis García 100 times because he was very...
I like it. He's a good player.
Creative player. Yeah. He was talented. And he was my player when I was in Tenerife. He was playing as a left winger. And after he was playing as a second striker, or he can play in any position, because he's clever. The movements are very good. And I said, listen, if you can keep the tempo of the Premier League, the high tempo of the Premier League, with your brain, with your game intelligence, between the lines, he will be a very, very good player. And he was. A little bit inconsistent, but he was very good because the movements, always we talk about, Sola was here. So these kind of players that they play between the lines are difficult to manage. And if they keep the tempo, it's fantastic.
You see, with that tempo there, Rafa, in respects of like English players, they're always saying we're not technically good enough and our game is fast. Can we have technically good enough players playing at that tempo for a consistent time in the game?
Yeah, but it's not something that will happen tomorrow. You have to keep working with academies. You have to analyze the structure of the academies that they are trying to improve now. And then you have to coach them properly. One problem that you can see in England is you have a very good player in one team and another one in another team and another one in another team. And you cannot go and then sign these players because, you know the rules. In Spain, you have four or five players in Barcelona, four or five in Madrid. They play together, they learn from each other, they improve because they have players with quality around them. Mm-hmm. And here is one. And after, between 18, 21 years old, here you cannot play.
Yeah.
And in Spain we had, before was the under-19 league, or you can play in second division, in championship, when you are 19 years old. And here you go to these divisions and normally you don't play because you are too young, or the style of football is too physical, and then you have to wait 1 or 2 years to, and you lose. We had Scott Carson, the keeper, and it was for 1 year on the bench with Leeds. So he cannot improve. So if you don't change this, you will not improve the level of the young players.
Talking about like improve, and you mentioned Barcelona and Real Madrid there. They're saying in the Champions League, it's going to be one of these two teams. Is it that simple, Rafa? Because like you mentioned, Bayern Munich really disposed of Basel. But for me, if you can beat Barcelona, you most probably win.
Yeah, I agree with you that Barcelona and Madrid are, for me, one step ahead of the others. I was impressed with Bayern because I was watching the last three games of Bayern Munich and I was there in the stadium and they were quite good, really good. But they have very good wingers, striker, second striker, even a midfielder. So Steiner is coming back from injury. That will be a big boost for them. But they still, they have some problems maybe in defense. And if you play against Madrid or if you play against Barcelona, you cannot make mistakes. No?
I got to say, when Atletico Bilbao played Manchester United the other week and they beat them at Old Trafford, I was thinking that there was going to be a reaction when Manchester United played over in Bilbao, but it wasn't. It actually beat them even more over in their place. What outcomes, a team like this, I think they're seventh in the Spanish league. Manchester United are now gone to the top. How comes a team like that just passed and made Man United look so embarrassing? Maybe you need to send your app to Alex.
No, it's the mentality of the players. No, you know, San Mamés, the stadium is amazing. No?
I've never heard so much noise. I remember, I can't really say that Portsmouth is the same, but like the noise continuously, even when the Athletic Bilbao players make the ball go out of play, they were still clapping them, saying, well done.
Liverpool was similar.
Liverpool was like this.
And Besiktas was amazing when we played against them in the Champions League. But anyway, coming back to Athletic and San Mamés, it's a massive stadium for the fans. The fans and the players, the club, they stick together because it's the philosophy of the Basque. We want to bring Basque players, so they stick together. They work very hard. They had Caparrós, the coach, 2 or 3 years with a style similar to this one, very, very tough. And Bielsa was doing the same. The players, they have quality. You see Muniain or you see Llorente.
Yeah.
They have some good players. And the mentality is really good. The fans on top of the other team. So everything was perfect. And the pitch is fantastic.
Fantastic surface. Do you see with Muniain? I know that Llorente will definitely go. Will Muniain, as a 19-year-old, he look like a good player? Has he got a chance maybe to break into the squad or is he still too young?
No, I think he's doing well. He's playing for the under-21. He's with the national team, with the senior players. He will be around. I think he has the character. He has the quality, the game intelligence, and he's working very hard because you cannot find... Normally, the players with talent, they don't work so hard. So, and they are working, everyone is working very hard because they have the belief now.
How long did it take you to actually to get the app going and that? Is it because you've got the time at the moment?
It's done.
It's done and ready to go? And how long did it take you to get it going, like from start to finish? Is it like months, a year, 18 months?
Sorry, the
To build the app and make it come and now it's ready to go. How long?
No, it's ready.
It's ready?
Yeah.
Is that right? So what's going to happen? Is that you're gonna use that to take into like a new job, for instance, like your name was mentioned with the Chelsea job?
Yeah. Can I show you?
Yes, please do.
If you go to watch a game, so you can prepare.
And it's very simple.
So can you do it like this? So for instance,
you go for somebody, say, I want to see Basel, you say Bayern, options, I want to see, let me see, all teams. Mm-hmm. All teams here. Okay.
So this is their style of play. This is what they okay.
The system part. You say I will change positions. You go here, then you say, I want to see the team. But I want to move players because he has to play here. He has to play there. So you can do it. But you can go to the library and you say match animation library, and Dortmund switch of play. Okay. Yeah. You go there, and you say okay play. You can maybe go to 50.
Right.
You have the movement.
Uh-oh.
Switch your play. Simple.
Wow.
You say, I will go to another one with all the team.
So this kind of system, would you be able to like have this plugged up somewhere, Rafa, where you could actually show it to the whole team on how, for instance, if you was at Chelsea now, because you was linked with Chelsea, they put your name in Chelsea. So if you had the Chelsea team now, would you be able to put the team what you wanted to play against, like, for instance, the other day, the Napoli team?
You can choose both teams. You can put your system, their system. You can connect because we use normally a system Amisco that is like ProZone that you can watch the clips at the same time. So you can create your own animation with your system, their system, the movements that you want to do, the movement that they will do. You can copy everything and put in a big screen.
Unbelievable. I still got to ask you about the Chelsea speculation. Is there any truth in that speculation, or just because you're?
I think that because at this time Villas-Boas was under pressure, so they were talking and talking. But at the end, I didn't have any proper offer on the table. Yeah. So they were talking about what they want. They want to win the Champions League, all these things. So I was linked a little bit with the Champions League.
Rafa, with this job, the way the chairman is, if you're a manager who's trying to do something, build something, he doesn't give people a chance. It must be a scary job to take.
Yeah, yesterday some coaches, we were talking about this, you know, and I have the experience in Italy and in Spain, so after 1 or 2 weeks, you are under pressure.
Yeah.
And that is not the way, because the players are clever and they know when the manager has a power or has the control. So I think it's important to analyze the profile, to analyze the managers, okay, what they want is this, and then carry on with him.
And I've got to say as well, Rafa, Fernando Torres, a striker who I very, very much admire. I almost now feel very sorry for him. What happens to somebody who is of the level that he is and the level that he's reached? Why now is he play? He hasn't scored for so many games. What has happened? What can they do for him?
As a striker, you know that you need confidence. So I think that he has lost a little bit of confidence. But talking about the game, Napoli, Chelsea, Napoli, he went from the bench and he was working very hard. Mm-hmm. He was trying. He knew that his team needed legs, fresh legs, and he was working. He was pressing. He was doing what the manager told him because he was playing a little bit on the right.
Yeah.
And I think that is the attitude. I think that he will come back. He will be again the Fernando Torres that we know. But he will need time. And also he has another problem, is that Drogba is scoring goals and he's playing well. So then you cannot play. If you play with the two strikers, you have to change the system. So if you play with Drogba up front, he has to wait. Mm. But he knows that he has to keep working hard and be ready.
Will he go to the, will they still take him to the Euros because you've got Soldado, Llorente?
But I was talking with Del Bosque before and he said everybody has a chance. But for experience, I will say to you, it's better don't say too much because still 2-3 months to play. Could be injuries.
Yeah.
So everybody was talking, Soldado is not going. Then Soldado is in the national team now. Yeah. But could be the same for any other one.
Okay. And just before you go, Rafa, I've got to ask you, England, the Euros, can anybody really beat Spain? I think Germany might have a good chance, maybe. But what about England, Rafa? Give me something.
Germany is improving. France is doing well. Spain is doing really, really well against Venezuela. They play a fantastic game. England, they won't have time maybe to prepare everything. They know each other, but you have to have a plan. You have to have an idea. You have quality. You have players that they have the potential, but you need an idea. If you have an idea, if you have a system, then they will follow this idea, they will follow the manager, and they will have the belief that is the key.
Yeah, but the thing is, Raf, we actually haven't even got a manager.
Yeah, I know that there's is a problem. People say, no, it's not important because you will not have a friendly or just one friendly. I think that it's important to know who is in charge and how he will prepare. He will see the players, he will talk to the players, he will be preparing mentally the players for the Euros.
And do you want to, I've got to ask you, Rafa, do you want to come back to England or would you take a job abroad?
No, I am really pleased here, very happy, my family settled down. I know that the Premier League is a fantastic league that you can work. So you can say, this is my plan, and then they will give you time. And I am quite confident that with a good plan, with support, we will do well, like we did it in the past. No?
Nice one. Listen, Rafa, all the very best of the app. It's a great app.
Yeah.
I feel like I know stuff already, off the back of your
app. No, I can guarantee you that you will enjoy.
Thanks very much, Rafa.
Cheers.